All right, Elisha Baza is a Nigerian media entrepreneur, and he joins us now. Thank you for joining us. All right, so this is What Are You Saying? And he is a developing app specialist, right? And he has an app called
Wits Prep. Yes.
In fact, I read that app and I was wondering, okay. So I now went on Google to search for Wits Prep. And you have quite an interesting app.
Yeah.
It helps people prepare for examinations.
Yeah.
WAEC,
NECO,
JAMB.
And other O-level
things. You know the first thought that came to me, God forgive me. I said, will I allow my children go to the junior school? I said, why you not put it? TOEFL, SAT, you know, IGCSE,
IELTS.
I'm sure if you put IELTS there, you have more downloads than regular people because everybody wants to travel to Canada.
Yeah, on there.
All right, that's an aside. You know, so what also you know prompted you to go into the business of app development in Nigeria?
I wouldn't say I purposely wanted to develop an app. I have a media background, and with my experience in
radio and TV,
production, and what's it called, distribution as well, I kind of found out that there's so much content distributed to young people, entertainment-based content, and so I felt, what about we develop something like a Netflix for education? So where people can enjoyably consume educative content and it impacts their life and changes the entire education.
So I do things on education.
Yeah.
Right? So every year we organize a board game tournament for children. We bring in about 2,000 to 3,000 children.
Great.
Ages 5 to 19. Yeah. They participate in chess, Scrabble, and our local Ayolopon game. Okay. And I've done that since 2017.
Yeah.
In fact, this year I'm trying to give it a rest because every year is a tug of war getting sponsorship when it comes to educational things.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people are losing interest in academic or educational activities and moving towards the entertainment. So when I saw your app, it's actually everybody is geared towards, you know, so how engaging is this app? And, you know, is it truly meeting that goal?
So I'd say we just launched.
Awesome. Okay.
Our major focus is to reimagine the way education is delivered. Before now, people preparing for exams, we just stand up and go for
a tutorial
center. Or if you have the money, you can hire a home lesson teacher. So in this case, we want you to learn at your own pace. We want you to watch videos, not long, boring videos. Videos that are interactive. You can also interact with other learners everywhere. You can ask directly the tutor. You can ask questions based on what you have just learned. So it's really comprehensive. After everything, you also have, it's not just watching videos. After everything, you can also
take some tests and all that.
Practice questions.
And see how far you've gone.
Yes, to gauge your understanding of what you have just
Okay, so watched. I was going to ask, what is, and I'm glad you mentioned that you have done a bit of in a distributive space.
Yes.
So how are you planning to get this your app to solve our educational problems?
Well, so there are different phases. Yeah?
Okay.
First phase is make sure your content is great. Make sure you have developed something that's able to change the space, something that people can understand better, right? But then you also need to educate people that something like this exists as well.
So how do you do that? So I would want to think that you collaborate with schools to do that.
So it's actually a complex thing for now. Some schools look at you as,
and you're coming like a competition. You are like a competition for them.
So imagine going to a tutorial center and you say, look, this thing can, we present it as a as something that will complement your efforts. It's much more like a more interesting way of reading a book. So you get some pushbacks, and then
you definitely get some pushbacks, especially in Nigeria, that they don't understand. And this thing, I was just telling her that a lot of people don't understand that the way to go global is collaboration.
Yes,
you cannot sit on your own and say that you will not collaborate. Yes. The reason Waze is here today is because we decided that we wanted to collaborate with, you know, Plus TV. So it's that's how it works when it comes to scaling, if you want to scale your business. But two interesting things that I've observed: both apps is localized. Well, his is a bit, you can use it anywhere, but yours is quite localized.
Yeah,
you know, is it because you're looking at it that we have the numbers here in Nigeria and you don't need to have any other person probably from Ghana downloading, or somebody from, you know, is that it?
So over the years I've done business across Africa. So I know, for instance, that there's resistance, right? People prefer consuming local content first.
Depends. So,
well, so what I'm
Brazilian
saying...
Brazilian has no local content.
So if it's, if it's from another African country...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay, I get you.
There's a steep
there's
resistance.
There's no Ghanaian here.
Yeah. There's no Ghanaian here, yes.
So, for instance, for me to replicate this in Ghana, I have to use
localize it
tutors.
Yeah.
I have to make sure that I sell it to them as Ghanaian.
Yeah.
That I understand what they are going through. I understand their challenges, and
their
then I'm
system.
Delivering what their needs are, or meeting their needs directly.
Awesome.
So that's the approach. Yeah. We localize for every single country.
So how is this app doing? Because my children, and interestingly, they do Khan Academy. I'm sure you would do Khan Academy. Then also, what's this one? The green one, IXL.
Yeah.
You know, they've done that for a very long time. And it has really helped because it made analysis interesting for them, you know, from a very young age. So my sisters, all of us, we're all on IXL.
Yeah.
I mean, all our children, if you come to me, you go on IXL because I want every child to succeed.
Yeah.
So for this now, you're not trapping them at a young age, you know, because you're doing WAEC and all of those. So what is the package that you're thinking to prepare? Because I believe for us to, the truth is that the future is technology. Apps is actually the future, because go and look at it. If I give my child this phone today, before I come back, if I had only 10 apps, I'll come back and I will meet 50 apps on my phone, and they are using every one of it.
Mm-hmm.
They are not like us adults that we are like dry fish. We can't be changed.
Wow.
You know,
I'm just saying.
There are very few adults that actually use apps, but I've seen children download 20 apps and they are using it. So why are we not? So what are we doing to trap, you know, them from that young age?
Okay, so this is a very extensive project for us.
Yeah. Okay.
I would say right now it's an entire learning platform. I would say first it's not just WAEC, JAM, NECO, and SSE. We have already it's already on the app as well. We produced something for primary schools.
Awesome.
For common entrance. For both the local common entrance and the ones for international schools. So like SSAT, ISEE, the one for Catholic schools, TACH.
Awesome.
Okay.
We've created that. So it's a step-by-step process, you know? And so before you know it, after a period of time, would have touched your
IELTS. Awesome. So we're looking SSAT. For WITS prep. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So let's go back to our audience. Before they will say we are not asking their questions. So somebody is saying, "Hello, Waze. I'm currently watching. Please, what is the name of the app aside from, and he said, and aside from the local from the app being local, why should I pick up this app over others?" He's referring to your app.
Well, I think I answered that earlier.
Yeah, but what's the name of your app?
My Flair. That's MYFLAIR. Flair menstrual app.
Okay,
you see
okay.
it on iOS and you see it on the Android as well.
Awesome.
So we have both versions. So again, I would say I was talking to you about a feature that is about to be activated, which is a feature for people who are, for example, trying to get pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the feature helps the spouse to share information, the wife share information with the husband.
Mm.
So when it's your period for conceiving, which is the ovulation period. You can get an automatic. Oh, you can customize the message. You can send something like, it's getting hot in here.
Okay. Okay, really hot in here. Okay, so what is the business now? Let's go.
Okay, so I was even going to ask, is there a law that governs the tech space? How does the law or how do policies, government policies, affect tech business?
That's a fantastic question.
So the first major law that you find out has to do with usage of data.
Okay.
And that's why you have the GDPR and you have the NDPR, which is the Nigerian version. And it talks about how you use the information you collect from people, how you protect the information you collect from people, you know, so particularly sensitive information. So, for example, I just told you now that the wife will be able to share information with the husband. How do you protect that information to make sure that while she's sharing with the husband, it's somebody not being shared with somebody.
Yeah.
You know, then two, there are instances around labor laws, around pregnancies and all that. What if you don't want this person to know that you're pregnant? Am I going to share your information with your employer? You know, so a whole lot of concerns around privacy issues. So these are all things that when you're developing an app can also quote unquote pile up your costs.
Because of the code, the extra code,
you need to put extra.
Can people hack into app the way they
anybody can be hacked into.
Whoa.
Anybody.
As far as it's in the tech space.
Anybody can be hacked into.
Those are the things that brings the cost up.
Yeah, so by the end of the day, if somebody really wants, and there are different types of hacks. There's what is called denial of service.
Yeah, you know, they hold you for ransom.
All sorts. But by the end of the day, you have to try as much as possible to make sure that you put things in place. You also let your users understand what they are getting themselves into.
So what's the average cost of, okay, so today now I have one crazy idea and it's growing in my head and I want to now create an app for it. What cost am I looking at, you know, as a Nigerian?
It depends if you're doing web and mobile.
Okay.
If you're doing mobile, if you're doing iOS. iOS apps are typically more expensive than if you're doing Android apps. Oh, yes, it is. Again, if you, apart from
because
the development...
The restrictions on the phone itself is problem.
Which is why you... I don't want to be an Apple spokesman, but the truth is that you find out that the process for getting your app on iOS is way, way, way more stressful.
Stringent, yeah.
No, stressful, not stringent. It's stressful. The amount of money you pay is also on an annual basis instead of your Android, where it's a one-off fee, and it's even less. With iOS, they want to be sure you know what you're doing. They want. There are certain things you can't do.
Well, I feel that Nigeria, we're not in the iOS market yet.
Oh, we are in the iOS market.
Have you been to Dubai?
Don't you use iPhone?
I do. I'm saying that we are the, like, maybe 10%. I'm telling you, you know, because when I did a visibility study, someone was saying to me that if you want to create an app in Nigeria, if you don't have money, focus on the Android, because version. The Android users in Nigeria, for instance, they are much more, in fact, not only Nigeria, a lot of African countries are much more than the iOS users. So maybe when you have made money from that, this you can now decide to go and add an iOS, you know.
Again, it depends on the package you're getting.
So
it depends on the people you are targeting.
The cost vary.
It varies.
For an average, your own.
So my own app is different from his.
Yes, and his will be way more expensive than
mine.
But
you have people that you'll be videoing now.
Exactly. Content, developing that content.
We are talking about cloud here. Cloud storage. For every video that is watched, it's just like comparing Netflix
with what you have.
With WhatsApp.
Whoa.
They are different.
Yeah.
So whatever you want to develop, you have to get proper costing for it. I cannot say there is a range for developing apps.
Oh my goodness. People have kept me in that.
So back to the business. How do people, because monetize. I know exactly, because I know that there's a guy that has the idea, he's the one that writes all the codes, but he's not a businessman because they're two different things.
Yeah. Yeah.
So how do you incorporate that business part into the development?
How do you monetize? How
do you make money off it?
So for standard way, just like media, for instance. One of the major ways people, media companies make money is either through
adverts,
and nowadays through video on demand, through subscription. So media companies like Netflix and the likes can also make from subscriptions. Same thing for apps as well. Most apps generate revenue through advertising and subscription. So you subscribe.
But the subscription that you're talking about, are we paying for that subscription? Or, you know, there are some apps that when you're downloading, is a free download.
Yeah.
Right? So you don't have a monthly fee that you pay. But there are some apps that they give you everything free.
Yeah.
You know, so... Yeah. For yours, it is actually you have to be on a subscription, an annual subscription.
Yes. So, for just like Netflix, for instance, I keep saying Netflix because mine is like an education.
But in a video,
Netflix, yeah. So I would say mine is subscription based. It's annually. You pay per course, per subject, for an entire year. So let's say you pay 2,000 naira. For economics for the whole year as an SS1 student, so you have access to all the videos,
SS1 materials,
all the entire thing. So it's subscription based or advertising.
So, but I want to come to you, Shem. So if it's the free apps now, how do they make money? It's just purely on advertisements, or do they give you? So if you have like, if I have 10,000 downloads on with my app, I've 10,000 users, and somebody else has 1 million users. Does it vary in terms of the kind of revenue?
Okay, so if you look at the Play Store, there's something called AdMob.
Okay.
Now, if you look at Google, there's something called AdSense.
Okay.
Now, what typically happens is that depending on the number of people you have, they show ads. I'm sure you've seen it. If you look at children when they're playing games, so after they've played the game, after they've played the game and they've lost all their lives, then they have to either wait for maybe 1 hour or they can watch 3 videos.
Yeah.
Do you get? If they watch the 3 videos, then they can continue. Now, those 3 videos that they are watching, the owner of the videos have paid. You understand? So that's a way to monetize. Another way to monetize, which is why you have what is referred to as the freemium model. So the part of it is free, a part of it is premium.
Yeah.
So there are certain features that they would unlock. So for example, most of our features as we're bringing them out now are free. And that's because we're trying to get more people to download and we're trying to have more stickiness. Now, once we have a lot of stickiness, we can start introducing premium service. So there is a particular, look at the chat with the doctor, for example. You can chat with the doctor for free, but the doctor you're chatting with is being paid. You understand? Now, what we do as a way to make money off that is if there is an issue that is way beyond the scope of just a normal tele conference with the doctor, then you have to go see an actual doctor. You pay to see the actual doctor. So we have partnerships with some hospitals. You get, so when you have the partnership with them, by the time you pay with those guys,
there are different channels.
There are different channels that you can make money.
I love that because even with LinkedIn, you know, LinkedIn
starts. There's LinkedIn premium.
There's a premium now.
Yes.
So if you want to now reach the real.
Exactly. So LinkedIn, for example, will show you maybe 2 people viewed you. They'll tell. They said 10 people viewed you. If you want to see the many people viewed you,
you have to go on the premium.
Then you can also hide your status. You know, then again, when people are searching for. So that's another model. When people are searching for people with particular skills, by the time you have a gold icon,
you will be the first person to pick.
So if you're looking for a job, you pay for the premium service, then people see you.
All right, so thank you so much, Elisha and Shem, for coming. I really learned a lot. We'll do a background gist after the show.
On the WhatsApp.
Yes, you can watch a repeat broadcast on Mondays, Saturdays, and Sundays at 3 p.m. Now, it's been an amazing conversation. Thank you so much. So, and remember to keep all the conversations going on all our social media platforms as we continue to hear what you are saying. Now, in case you missed today's quote, I live on my phone. I have a bunch of news and information apps there. That's from Warren Ellis. I think everybody lives on their phone now. It's not just Warren. All right, thank you so much again for coming.
Thank you, AK. We did this.
All right, so enjoy the rest of your evening. Tomorrow, we have all the ladies, so keep a date.